Hey guys, Sean T. Phillips to the brand new DVD Blu-ray Tuesday Sean video today. Taking a go out today, since came out today, see if things are on sale. And today though, new release wise, there's actually quite a few new things coming out. I had to write everything down to make sure I didn't like forget anything. One of the things coming out today, that this movie though, for some reason, I'm very dyslexic, so I was very convinced that the actual original title for this movie was Chop Shop for some reason. I thought it was like a West Coast chopper kind of thing. I don't know why I was convinced that, but it's a movie called Cop Shop. It's not called Chop Shop, but like I said, I was convinced of that title. One of the other ones releasing today is Dear Evan Hansen. Also, for the first time on 4K, Who Framed Roger Rabbit is releasing. And with that one, I believe there's going to be, I think I saw something for a Best Buy exclusive steelbook. I have a feeling, though, that's going to be one of those steelbooks that goes really fast. There's probably none left. But that is one that if it is there, I'm probably going to get that one, the steelbook. If not, though, I'll just get the regular edition. The other one was a movie today called Ron's Gone Wild, which I think is either a Disney or Pixar one. I don't know a whole lot about that one, though. But I know that one is releasing today, and I don't know if there's exclusives for that one. And also, though, another one coming out today for the very first time on 4K, it's a 4K combo pack, which has a 4K and the Blu-ray, is Krampus, and it's coming out in a brand new cut of the film called The Naughty Cut. So that's one of the other ones that's releasing today as well. And also, though, at the end of this video, it's going to be a whole bunch of brand new DVD, Blu-ray, and 4K reviews for some things I received to review and talk about for you guys. So as always too, let me know in the comments below what you guys thought of the DVDs, Blu-rays, and 4Ks that I reviewed, if you guys have seen them, and also if you guys plan on picking any of them up. But anyway though guys, let's get going and see what we can find today.
Into Target we go.
And I also want to let you guys know some really exciting news in case you guys haven't seen it yet. Yesterday I posted up the trailer from the new film which I directed, Amityville Bigfoot, which I am so excited about this movie. Guys, I absolutely cannot wait for you to see this movie. It's one of those things where I feel like there's going to be a lot of really crazy surprises in this movie, but the trailer is up now, and I'll put a link below for it if you guys have not seen that one yet. But like I said, thanks again those of you guys who have been checking it out and like the really nice comments and everything on it. But you guys can see, like I said, I'll have the link below for it if you have not seen it yet. You guys can comment on it underneath of this video or underneath the trailer itself, and definitely feel free to share it around and all that kind of stuff as well. But like I said, I'm so excited about this movie. I had such a fun time making it, so really looking forward to hearing what you guys think of the trailer. But now, you know, fingers crossed, hopefully they have some of the stuff out in here. It's a little bit later, it's like 2, so I feel like they should have this stuff out, but since it's a little bit later, there's a good chance that steelbook is probably gone at Best Buy, but we'll see though, but you never know.
Well, let's take a look here right in the front and see if anything was changed out here. And like I always show in this front, it's every so often they change it. It seems kind of like picked over right now here in the front. You see like a bunch of different empty spots. Like what is, oh yeah, so they have the spaces for the stuff. They haven't put them out though. So you see like they were going to change them. So Dear Evan Hansen here, $24.99 for the Blu-ray. Rick and Morty, that was one of the other ones today. The Blu-ray's $22.99 and then $17.96 for the DVD. And then Cry Macho and Candyman, those were a couple weeks back. And this was one of the other ones today, the Jesus Music one, Ron's Gone Wild. And then I guess one of these, so that's the Blu-ray, the DVD. I guess then there's no exclusives. Random like prepaid card back there, but no. Let's check over in the actual section though and see if maybe over there they have the stuff out. But as of right now, here in the front, I haven't really seen it like this before in this store where the spaces are here, but the stuff hasn't been put. But we'll see over in the actual section though and see if the stuff has changed. Like I said, you never know. Fingers crossed. You know, we shall see.
But yeah, in there though, in the actual section itself, it was like totally bare. There was absolutely nothing changed out at all. I mean, it was fully empty there. Nothing from last week or anything. So very strange. So I guess they just have not gotten to change anything out, or the movies like didn't come in or something. That could have been the thing that might have happened. I don't know. Or they just didn't get put out. But usually they've been on the ball lately with everything being out. So very strange everything was out, you know, was all empty like that. But gonna go over to the Walmart over here. This one, you know, never has the stuff out, but you never know, maybe today, since, you know, this one didn't have anything out, they're gonna change it all up and kind of be like, you know, kind of go against the grain of not having, because they always don't have stuff out, so they're gonna go against the grain of not, like they normally do, of not having things out. And since Target decided not to have the stuff out, maybe they're going to do, you know, change it all up and decide to have it all out. You never know. Crazier things have happened. But we'll go over there, though, and see. You know, like I said, fingers crossed they have it out over there. If not, though, we're going to go to another Walmart as well. And like I said, it's not going to probably be looking good for that Roger Rabbit steelbook. Like I said, I'm pretty sure there's a steelbook. I might be, like, talking out my arse or something about it, but I'm pretty sure there is a Roger Rabbit steelbook I saw pictures of. But either way, I'll get the regular one, but that, even the regular one might be gone by the time we get there since it's getting late. But we shall see, though.
Into Walmart we go. Well, the first Walmart we go.
And I want to ask you guys if any of you guys have this crazy, like, fear when you walk around in Walmart as well. Because I don't know if, like, I always come at, like, the wrong times when they're doing, like, the pallets. And they're, like, dragging real fast the pallets of, like, you know, products and stuff like that. New things that they're moving out and everything. And I always have this terrible fear that thing is going to run over my foot and, like, break my foot. I don't know. It's, like, this terrible, like, it's, like, this ongoing thing that I always have in here that I'm thinking, one of these days, I'm going to break my foot. I don't know if I'm the only one that thinks that, but I always am, like, convinced of that one of these days it's going to go run right into me or break my foot.
But I have not peeked yet, so let's see what's going on over here. I see something new over here. I know this is definitely something I don't remember seeing, this Monkey King Reborn one. I see a lot of spots, though, here. So I see, like, Werewolves Within, Amityville Call, 13 Minutes, Last Shoot. So some of these ones were ones that came out today, like Dear Evan Hansen. And I feel like Cry Macho might have been today, but I can't remember for sure. The Jesus Music. So yeah, there's a lot of different ones down there today. But then on the actual front here, I see like an ad for the Jesus Music one here, but I don't see any of the new ones out. The spots are here, like Ron's Gone Wild. The Blu-ray is $24.99, the 4K is $29.96. I don't know much about that one. Somehow that one kind of came and went. I guess I just didn't know. I didn't pay attention to that one at all. So I don't know much at all about that one. If you guys have seen that one, though, let me know if that's worth checking out. Other than that, though, right here in the front, I don't see anything new here. I was seeing if they have that Simpsons one here, and I actually did put that together. I actually got that Simpsons arcade one. That's the first thing that I've actually gotten, like, any of those kind of things, and the first actual, like, purchase that I've had in forever of anything. So it's like, but it took me hours to put it together. I mean, like, it was probably like 3 hours. It was so confusing for me, but I figured it out. I don't know how I did it with my brother, but that was a task to get that together. But looking over here, though, I'm not seeing anything different that I don't recognize from the last couple weeks. I think it's all stuff in the last few weeks here. Not noticing anything mixed in different. But like I said, we're going to go to another Walmart, and hopefully that one has out all the new stuff, because there definitely was a handful of things. And I don't know what some of these ones were today, like 13 Minutes and Last Shootout. I don't know what that one is either. So I'm definitely interested in seeing what those ones were as well. Into the second Walmart we go, and fingers crossed, hopefully they have something out, because, like, imagine if today was like one of those days when you didn't see one of the new things at all at anywhere. Even Best Buy, it was like a strange surprise and nothing was out, but we shall see. Though it's funny, I was walking over here and I saw they have like these old school, like, wacky racers and stuff like that. They're like these old model kits and stuff like that, the ones that you have to put together in like paint and stuff like that. But that's so weird, I haven't seen like anywhere have these. Oh, there's even one for Christine, $24.99 Christine one of the Christine car that you can put together. I remember these are really hard to do. I only ever did them like once in my life, put something like that together. But that's definitely funny. I've never seen those kind of things in like a long time. Like those aren't even something I was a kid. Those are just sort of like real old school. But let's head back here and hopefully, like I said, fingers crossed they have this stuff out today, because there definitely are some new stuff to show. There's some kind of a hit movie thing here. I don't know what this stand is. It's got some holidays, kind of a mixture of stuff. But let's see back here. I am seeing some new stuff. So luckily enough, it looks like some of the things are out. I don't see that Ron's Gone Wrong movie right here, but I do see, let's see some of the new things. They do have Rick and Morty here, season 5. And then they have the season 5. Yeah, I showed a steelbook version at the end, and it might have been exclusive to a specific store. I didn't know for sure, though, when I showed it where it was exclusive to. But it's $24.99 for the Blu-ray, $19.99 for the DVD. There's one here, a Paw Patrol one here called Pup Save the Day one. Let's see, anything else down here. There's one thing called One Shot. This one here, Cop Shop here, is $22.99 for the Blu-ray, $17.96 for the DVD. Let's see over here on the side, is there anything else? I don't see anything else new here. I did spot a few things new over here though. So let's see what was new here. So they do have Creepshow season 2, which I watched like every single episode of this one. I thought this was a very fun show. Not every single episode was like perfect, but I still did really like it. Let's see some of the other ones today was Werewolves Within, and I'm gonna talk about this one at the end of this video. That's $9.96 for that one. It's funny though, the one thing that the other Walmart had out, this one doesn't, the Monkey King one. And then this one here, Amityville Cult. This one, you know, released today as well. And then that one is on $9.96. It's always very hard to put these back. And there's one movie here, so I don't know anything about this one. This has a bunch of people in it. Thora Birch is in the movie. Amy Smart. This one here called 13 Minutes. This looks kind of interesting. If you guys have seen this one, though, let me know how this one was. Like I said, I don't know anything about that one. And then I think this one might have been last week. This one here, The Last Shootout. I think that might have been last. I might be wrong about that. And then also that they do have the Jesus Music one here. And that one is $14.96 for that one for the Blu-ray. And then $9.96 for the DVD. And then they have this one over here too. This I think it's an Asylum one here. That's like Apes versus Monsters. It's always so weird because some of these ones they put on DVD and other ones they don't. Like the one that I was in for them like a year ago, the Asteroideageddon one, they never put that one out on DVD or Blu-ray in the US. Hopefully they will, you know what I mean? You never know. It's always hard to know which ones they're going to put out on physical media with them. Also though, I think this one was today, this one Miracles, The Girl Who Believes in Miracles for $12.96. And then this one here, Show Me the Father, I believe from the creators of War Room, Courageous. I think that was today as well. Let's see if there's anything else mixed in over here. It's like randomly mixed in, because sometimes there's like random things in here and stuff like that. But no, I don't see anything else randomly in here. It seems to be all the same stuff from the past couple weeks. So as far as I can tell, not really seeing anything else different. Into Best Buy we go. So we're going to head back and see, and hopefully they've got this stuff out. And so I do see the Rick and Morty here. This is when I was talking about, the Steelbook version. And I don't know if it's exclusive to anywhere, because it's season 5. They do one that's a non-Steelbook, and it doesn't say Best Buy exclusive. So I'm not sure if it is exclusive to Best Buy or not. This is one of the other things that released today, which is a really cool Steelbook for Street Fighter. And this one is $24.99 for that one, but that was one of the ones that came out today. Also, though, today as well, like I was saying, was Dear Evan Hansen, and that one's $22.99 for that one here. Let's see if there's anything else new mixed in or anything. I'm just trying to make sure I don't miss anything here. Oh, they do have this one. Like I said, I can't remember if Cry Macho was this week or last week. I'm totally blanking on that. But this is the other one that came out today, this one, Ron's Gone Wild. Sorry, not wrong, Ron's Gone Wrong. I don't know much at all about this one. If you guys have watched this one, though, let me know if this one's worth checking out or not. That one's $29.99 for the 4K, and then $24.99 for the Steelbook. What's fun, not Steelbook, for the regular edition. What's weird, though, it doesn't seem like they have any exclusives. And I feel like this might be one of the first... Wait a minute, that's what is going on. This is not a Disney one. This is a Fox one. That's why there's no exclusive. I thought for at first this was a Disney movie, but no, it's a Fox movie. And that's why I was getting mixed up. Let's check over here. So maybe I was wrong about that Roger Rabbit thing, because I don't see anything Roger Rabbit here at all. So maybe I was imagining it. Let me just make sure that there's not like any other like spots that this could be. I'm like missing over it or something. But like I said, I felt like I saw something about a Roger Rabbit Steelbook. But let's see, they do have that for $22.99 for the Blu-ray, for the 4K, which is not a bad price for a 4K. I'm definitely, like I said, gonna get that though. Then $24.99 for Cop Shop. And then let's see some of the other ones. They do have the Krampus here as well, the brand new one I was mentioning that released today, and that one's $29.99 for that one. One of the other ones today too, and I forgot this was today, was the Karate Kid 4K 3 movie collection here. It doesn't include the fourth film though. I'm surprised too that they didn't put in the remake as well, just to have kind of all of them together in there, especially the fourth movie, because the fourth film definitely fits in the series, so it is weird that that's not included in there. Other than that though, let's see anything else here. Scrooge, I think that's like an old edition of Scrooge. They have this edition here, this the Ultimate Aang and Korra Blu-ray collection here for $74.99. They have the Jesus Music here for $14.99 here. Other than that, though, I'm seeing if there's anything else mixed in new that I'm not, that I'm, you know, missing or anything like that. But no, I don't see anything else. Like I said, I have to look on my phone too, just to check if there was a Roger Rabbit Steelbook. Because like I said, I for some reason feel like I saw something, but maybe I totally imagined it, which is what I might have done.
Yeah, so I looked online and there was a Best Buy exclusive Steelbook for that one, but when I looked on there, it was one of those kind of ones where it says like sold out. So like you can't even, there's not even an option for like a store pickup, at least as of right now, that's what it was showing as. But I did end up getting the standard version. And I like, actually the Steelbook, I looked at the picture of it, it's quite cool, but it's not like the absolute like coolest Steelbook, you know, imaginable. So I actually kind of like this image on this one anyway, but I always absolutely love this movie. This is like, to me, when I think of like, probably one of my, like, you know, on the list of like top watched childhood movies, this is definitely one of those ones up there with like the Ernest movies, Pee Wee's Big Adventure, and like certain ones that I just watched again and again, like, you know, obsessively. Especially, you know, Christopher Lloyd's character in this one is just so incredibly weird and everything. And I, you know me, I absolutely love weird characters and everything. But anyway though, guys, let me know in the comments below though if you guys saw the actual Steelbook one in your store. Also let me know what you guys picked up on DVD, Blu-ray, or 4K, if you guys picked up anything new today. As well, let me know, like I said, if what you guys thought of the trailer for Amityville Bigfoot. Really looking forward to hearing what you guys think of that one. Let me know too anything new that you guys have watched on TV, or any new films on streaming, or things you saw at theaters as well. And also be sure to let me know what you guys thought of the DVDs, Blu-rays, and 4Ks that are viewed at the end of this video. Anyway though, guys, now stay tuned for the brand new reviews. And the first ones I got here are from Arrow Video, and these are ones I just want you guys to know were available. And the first one here, I believe this is I feel like this is the second volume, because I have I showed this one a video or two back, this Giallo volume. I don't think it actually says like a volume number, but this was the first one here that was the Giallo's Essentials from Arrow Video. And this one that had the Possessed, the Fifth Cord, and the Pajama Girl case. But this is the newest one here I want to let you guys know is available. And this is the Giallo Essentials. This is the one in the yellow case. And this one has three different movies as well. This has What Have You Done... What Have They Done With Your Daughter's Torso, and Strip Nude for Your Killer. So these ones here, and they're in this limited edition case here. I'll show you guys a look inside here for this one. And this one has on here the limited edition contents, 2K restorations from the original camera negatives on What Have They Done to Your Daughter's Torso and Strip Nude for Your Killer. On here it has two versions of Torso, the original 94-minute Italian cut, as well as the 90-minute English cut as well on this one. And I'll show you guys a look at these discs here. So the first one, like I said, is Strip Nude for Your Killer here, and then there's Torso, and then, you know, What Have They Done to Your Daughters. This one, I'm very dyslexic, so some of the stuff I can get very dyslexic with the wording on these things and everything. But if you guys don't know what, you know, Giallo films are, basically they're whodunit films. It's all kind of all deals with, you know, murder, and it's kind of like if, like, someone was killed, and then it's kind of like the police are investigating, and it's kind of one of those things where it's like there keeps being people throughout the movie too that you kind of think could be the killer, and they kind of like allure that this person could be them, and then every time you think you might know who it is, then there's somebody else kind of weird comes along. There's lots of in Giallo films too, there's a lot of really strange, weird characters that are kind of like only there in a scene or two just to have like a weirdo, you know, to kind of confuse you, to make you wonder who the killer is. The other one here that is from Arrow Video, and this one I want to let you guys know is available, is a film here, Mill of the Stone Women here, and this is the two-disc limited edition version, and this has the brand new 2K restoration for the original camera negative by Arrow Video on here, and it has on here three different versions of the film. Four different versions of the film on here. It has a 96-minute Italian and English export versions, the 90-minute French version containing exclusive footage, as well as a 95-minute U.S. version containing alternate dubbing, ordered scenes on this one as well. But I'll show you guys, though, a look inside at this one. And it has in here a booklet which has stuff about the film, you know, like poster artwork, stills, that kind of stuff in here for the movie. And then there's also a mini poster for the film, and it's a two-sided poster, so it has the original, you know, poster image for the film, and then the brand new commissioned artwork for the movie here as well. And then I'll show you guys, though, a look inside here at the disc, and then in here too it has a couple like lobby cards as well, you know, like original like lobby card images, like promotional images and stuff like that for the movie as well. And here's a look though at the discs in here. So it's a 2-disc set here for this one, but a really, really cool release. Like I said, it has 4 different versions of the film on here. And then the last one here that is from Arrow Video as well as a movie, it's one you don't hear about too much, which stars Dan Aykroyd, which I always really liked this movie. And like I said, I don't know why it's one you don't hear about too often. And it's a movie called My Stepmother is an Alien. And this is one of those movies, I feel like I only discovered this movie. Like, I didn't see this one when this first came out. I think I saw it like, I think the DVD of this one, this is like years and years ago, probably like in like 99 or 2000 or something like that is when I first saw this movie. I never had seen this one until much later. And I don't know why. It's basically though about Kim Basinger's character who comes to Earth and she's like this alien. And then kind of she's sent to get information from Dan Aykroyd's character and then she kind of falls in love with him and it becomes this whole big thing. But it's a really, really fun movie. If you guys, like I said, if you've never seen this one, definitely want to recommend you guys check out. This has a brand new 2K restoration from the original camera negative on here. It has a brand new comedy track on here by critic Brian Ressman on here. It has a brand new interview on here with the director, theatrical trailer, image gallery as well on this one. And I'll show you guys though a look inside in here. There's a booklet as well with some stills from the film, stuff about the production as well for this one. And then the next one here, this is from Shout Factory Scream Factory line. This is a really cool release because I don't think that this has ever been released before, this edition. I don't think like in any other countries or anything like that, as far as I know. And this is the film Krampus, and this is the first time ever available on 4K as well. But it's also for the first time, as far as I know, this is the naughty cut. So this is the extended uncut version of the film that is on here. And it's, I think it's like, I don't know how many minutes longer it is on this one. And I don't know if these ones, like the stuff that was cut from this, you know, in this version had ever been, like I said, had been put on like the original Blu-ray release back in the day or anything like that for sure. I don't know for sure on that, but it has on here though. If you guys don't know this movie too, it's basically though all about set during Christmas, and it's like this family all together for Christmas, and it's kind of like they're all stuck in this sort of like, it's there's like this really creepy vibe to this one because Krampus comes, which is like this sort of like Christmas sort of demon that comes and collects like people and stuff like that. And basically he's coming and like coming after this family and everything, but it has this like creepy like empty feeling to the world. Like, I don't know, it's a very, very creepy movie. And it has on here though, like I said, it's a 2-disc version, so it has the 4K version of the film as well as the Blu-ray version of the film on here. It has gag reel, behind the scenes on here. It has deleted and extended scenes. It has brand new interviews on here, on this one here as well, a commentary track on here. Like I said, though, it's a really, really cool release here. I'll show you guys a look inside here as well, and it has the Blu-ray and the 4K version of the film here. And the next one here is from Universal, and they sent over a bunch of, like, promotional items with this one. Like, they sent over a mug here for the film Dear Evan Hansen. There's, like, a coffee mug. They sent over a notepad here. It says on here, today is going to be a good day, and here's why. So, Evan Hansen notepad, and also a hoodie, too. Like Evan Hansen's hoodie in here as well for the film. So that was cool. And it actually, it's like it's enlarged, so it actually fits. So I tried it. It's a little bit like, a little tightish, but it doesn't fit terrible. So it's definitely like, you know, I could wear Evan Hansen's jacket. But the movie here, like I said, is called Dear Evan Hansen. It's a musical film, and it's basically, though, you know, it's from the director who did, you know, Wonder, Perks of Being a Wallflower. It's basically, though, about, it's kind of one of those things about, like, where a lie and something that you say that, like, kind of gets out of control. It's basically about this kid, Evan Hansen, and, you know, it's kind of like he's not the super popular kid at school, and he has, like, you know, some emotional problems, and his therapist is telling him to start to write notes to himself and kind of like say the things that he needs to say, you know, to get this stuff out there. So kind of talk it out to himself and things like that. And he writes this one letter to himself. And then the one person that's in the library, like he prints it out, Evan Hansen's character prints it out. And then the guy in the library sees it and then gets crazy and thinks it's about him. And he's this guy too, who has like his emotional problems and everything. And then the guy ends up taking his own life the same night. And then the parents find that note and think that the note though, that Evan Hansen was writing to himself was to this guy. So then they end up thinking that it was this whole big thing, that they might have kind of had this relationship, but it becomes this whole big thing. And then Evan Hansen like tells this lie and says that, you know, that they were writing notes back and forth, and then he fakes these emails. And it's one of these things, like I said, where things just get spiraling out of control with these lies. And then he, like, Evan Hansen's character starts to like the one sister that killed himself and everything. It's a really well done movie, but it's just like one of those things where it's like things just get worse and worse. It has on here though, The Making of Dear Evan Hansen on here, and then some behind-the-scenes stuff on this one here as well. The next one here is from Universal as well, and this is one I just want you guys know is available. And this is, I don't know if there's going to be a Blu-ray version of this edition or not. This is the four-movie collection here of God's Not Dead. Like I said, just want you guys know that this was available, and this has God's Not Dead, God's Not Dead 2, God's Not Dead, A Light in the Darkness, and God's Not Dead, We Are the People. That's the newest one in the series here, and then each of the films is on, I believe it's on their own discs here, yeah, as well for this one. And then the next ones here are from Warner Brothers. They sent out a free copy of this one. Let you guys know this one is available. This movie, though, I absolutely love this movie. This is probably one of my favorite like things I've seen in the last like handful of months. That to me, like, really resonated. That's something that, you know, because I feel like nowadays there's not as much stuff coming out that I feel like is that amazing or like that's resonating to me as much anymore. And this one particularly, I really thought was really, really good. And this one here, directed by James Wan, Malignant. I absolutely love this because, like, it has this total throwback vibe. And James Wan too, he really loves a lot of like old school horror films, and he brings a lot of those styles to his movies, and that's what I really like. And you can kind of see too where he takes inspiration for certain things, like in the one Insidious, you kind of saw moments of Sleepaway Camp in there. I think in the second Insidious, I don't know, I always like when you can kind of see the moments of where he's kind of getting like inspiration and things like that from. And this one too, it almost felt like he got a little bit of inspiration from a recent movie called Knife and Heart, because there was a scene like with this knife in it, very different kind of knife, but like there was a shot of it when they were showing it, kind of reminded me of that. It also reminded me of Crimes of Passion, the shots when they were showing the knife. I don't know, there's just like these amazing sequences when like you see like the killer with the knife in the shop and stuff that I really, really liked. I also love the use of the Where Is Your Mind or something song. It wasn't done for the movie. I looked into it. I don't think it was for the movie. They changed it, but it was done like a band like did their own version of a number of years back. But it's basically though about this girl who's having these sort of weird type of visions and weird things around her, and basically weird people are dying around her, and it's extremely hard to explain. And I don't want to ruin anything about this one because it's one of those things where if you say too much about it, you're like destroy this movie and like give away stuff. And it's basically just my recommendation is this is a top recommendation. Watch this movie. Great music. Just the vibe of this I really liked. It had this mixture of like a giallo film mixed with like a giallo Italian horror, then like an 80s horror, and then also had like a 90s vibe as well, like Seven kind of feel. The Bone Collector feel a little bit. It had like all these sort of things kind of meshed into one, but definitely one I would recommend you guys check out. Has on here the Malignant, James Wan's vision on here, and then it has groundbreaking filmmaker takes us behind the scenes of his latest film on this one here as well. And the next one I got here is from Warner Brothers as well, and they sent our free copy of this as well to let you guys know this one is available. This is Clint Eastwood's newest film, Cry Macho. This is an interesting one. I didn't like this one, though, as much as I like The Mule. The Mule, I absolutely loved. You know, I always like when Clint Eastwood acts in his films and everything. And this one, like, I think I just liked his character so much in The Mule. And he just, like, got himself into so many crazy situations in that one and everything. But this is basically, though, he kind of, like, gets this job. It's kind of like a funny idea too when you think about it, because like Clint Eastwood's character is so old getting sent on this job to do this thing. But it's basically he gets sent by Dwight Yoakam's character, and he's like sent to go and get his son who lives in Mexico. And basically though, he has to go and like get the son who's in Mexico and get him away from the mother. So it becomes this whole thing when he gets there and everything, and then like the mother doesn't want to let the son go, and then like basically Clint Eastwood's character has to try and get the kid over the border into America, and then people are kind of coming after him from the mother and stuff like that. So it becomes one of these whole big things, and it has, you know, like it's kind of like essentially like a Western in a sense. It has that feel, but like in like a modern day, but like in Mexico and stuff like that. And like I said, I thought this was good. I did not like it as much though as I liked The Mule. and everything, but I still do would say this is still worth checking out, though. And this one has on here, though, feature-wise, the making of Cry Macho on here, on this one here, and then also a Cry Macho with the animal handlers on, well, on set. The next one here is from Warner Brothers as well. This is another one I want to let you guys know is available. And this is the Return film. It was an 80-minute film that they did for the show The Waltons. And they brought the show back, you know, The Return. And they have, you know, the one, was the character, is it John Boy? Am I mixing this all up? I think, yeah, John Boy, you know, who was in It. And he was in a bunch of stuff, but I always think of him from It. You know, he is in this, the film, because he was in the original series as well. And I don't think they had, I might be wrong, but I feel like there hasn't been anything Waltons related in, like, I don't know how long has it been, but it's, I'm pretty sure it's been a really, really long time that there's been anything, like, special related or anything like that. It makes you kind of hope that we'll see, like, a return of, like, the Brady Bunch with the people that are left, like, the kids back again now or something. It would be kind of cool, like, a actual Brady Bunch, like, movie or something again. And there's nothing confirmed about that, but I'm just thinking, like, seeing, like, the Waltons doing that, it would be kind of cool to see, like, something like that done for, like, a special movie. And the next one here is from Warner Brothers as well, another one I want to let you guys know was available and they sent over a free copy of. And this is the complete fifth season here on Blu-ray of Rick and Morty, and it's in a steelbook release. And it's a really, really cool steelbook. I put the sticker here, too, that just says exclusive, you know, special features, uncensored, just so I didn't forget to say that's the uncensored version, you know, of the series here. But I'm trying to remember, too, if they had ever done, you know, like a steelbook that wasn't like a limited edition or anything like that for this, because I don't believe, like, none of the stuff said anything about this being, like, exclusive to anywhere specific. So I don't think it's, like, you know, an exclusive one or anything like that. There's an ad in here, too, for that. And I got to watch this one at some point, that 8-bit Christmas movie. I know that's on HBO Max right now. It has the exclusive, you know, the digital copy as well. But on here, though, feature-wise, this has exclusive, you know, look at making of season 5, inside the episodes, featurettes on here. It has on here season 5 hype, explore the show's background and coloring process on here, a featurette on this one. But like I said, really, really cool steelbook release here for Rick and Morty, the complete fifth season here on Blu-ray. Now, the next one here, this is from Paramount, and this is the brand new Paramount Presents release version here of Howard and Maude, which is one of the movies that I have watched this movie throughout the years so many times. I absolutely love, too, you know, Cat Stevens' music in this movie, too. I feel like the music, too. It's one of these movies where the movie would not be the same if you took the music out. There's some things like that, too, where the music is such a huge part of the film. It's not like that in every movie, but, like, you know, some movies have kind of weird, bad music and stuff like that. But this movie, you know, everything is so good, and it works like that. Like I said, the music is pretty much another character of this film, the way that it plays. And it's essentially all about this kid who, you know, it's very, like, kind of like, you know, played by Bud Cort, very depressed and not a very happy kid. And he's always kind of, like, sad and kind of, like, pretending to kill himself and, like, you know, kind of pranking his mother. And kind of, like, you know, he comes from this rich background. He doesn't really want to play the game of the, you know, the rich lifestyle and the things that the mom wants him to do and stuff like that. And he ends up, you know, meeting Ruth Gordon's character, who's this much, much older woman. I think she's supposed to be 79 years old. And he's, like, they don't really say how old he's supposed to be. I think he's supposed to be like 19 or 18 or something like that. I don't think they say exactly how old he is, but it's this kind of thing where it's like they have this relationship and it's kind of like the people around them are giving them problems about it and everything. But it's a really, really good movie, and it's also extremely sad, like extremely sad. It has on here, though, a comedy track on here with Larry Karczewski and Cameron Crowe, and it also has you know, theatrical trailers on this one. And here's a look, though, inside. Here's the original poster artwork, which is a kind of a cool image, too, which I don't really even remember this poster for this one. So that's what's really cool about the Paramount Presents, is that they have, like, these, like, really early posters that you don't see too much. Here's a look, though, inside here at the artwork inside for this one. And this one did have a digital copy as well. I already put the thing on for that one. And the other one here, which is from Paramount, which I cannot believe that this movie now is 25 years old, because I can remember, like, it was yesterday seeing this movie in theaters. And I remember it so well. I remember the audience seeing this, and I remember, like, knowing, too, when I was seeing this, that this was the end of this series, that it was done, there wasn't going to be any more. And I remember I was real depressed. And it's, you know, this is Beavis and Butthead Do America here for the first time available, you know, on Blu-ray. Which I'm so glad now this is finally on Blu-ray. I absolutely, you know, like, grew up, you know, with Beavis and Butthead, like, as a teen. I guess it started when I was, like, 9 or 10 or something like that. I guess I guess probably 9 or 8 or 9, something like that. So I watched it really young. Always was a fan of Beavis and Butthead. I remember, like I said, remember seeing this one in theaters and absolutely loving this movie. And it's basically Beavis and Butthead going, you know, on this essentially like this road trip and stuff like that. And it's kind of like there's all this mistaken identity that happened along the way, and these people are coming after him, and the FBI are coming after them because they think they have, like, this explosives and all these type of things. It's just a great movie, great music on this one, too. And this one has on here a commentary track on here with Mike Judge, some featurettes on here, MTV News, celebrity shorts, trailers, TV spots on here. But if you guys have never seen the Beavis and Butthead Do America, you know, definitely one you guys have got to check out. The other one here is from Paramount that I want to let you guys know is available. And this is available for the first time on 4K, and this is now keep in mind though with this one it only includes the 4K version of the film and a digital copy. It doesn't include a Blu-ray, and this is the movie, you know, Martin Scorsese's The Wolf of Wall Street, which I saw this one in theaters and really liked this movie. And this one you know, has on here though The Wolf Pack, Running Wild, The Wolf of Wall Street Roundtable on this one here as well. But like I said, just one of the guys on this one was available, and it's The Wolf of Wall Street, and it has the 4K and as well as the digital copy as well of the film here. Now the next one here is from Kino Larber, and this is one that I had never seen before. This is from Kino's Studio Classics line, and this one has a great cast. It has like Malcolm McDowell, Daniel Stern is in here, there's a lot of musicians in here, and then lots and lots of different cameos, like Clint Howard is in here, Dick Miller. It's one here called Get Crazy, and there was a movie like this too that was kind of similar at the same time with Jeff Goldblum, which was like a disco kind of movie. And it was like they made a handful of movies like this around this time in the 80s, like late 70s, early 80s, that were like dealing with like clubs and disco kind of things and stuff like that. And this is basically though about like this playhouse that's putting on this play, and it's kind of like this crazy sort of play where they've all sort of weird things happen. This is kind of like all the behind the scenes go-ons of it, and the kind of like, it's almost like plays out like in a lot of ways like a parody a lot of the scenes too, kind of like some of them are a little bit like Airplane and that kind of a vibe. And this one has on here a brand new 2K master on here, approved by the director. Great transfer on this one. Commentary track on here with the director on here, as well as filmmaker Eli Roth and historian Daniel Kremer. Has on here the After Party documentary on here, fan fiction with No Dogs in Space featurette. Has trailers from Hell on here, 3 music videos, and a theatrical trailer on this one. The next one here is from RLJ Entertainment, and this is and I've watched through every single episode of this, and this is Creepshow season 2 here, which I really like this. I really like, you know, anthology series and everything. My favorite one on here of the episodes was probably the one, like the vampire one with Molly Ringwald in it. That was probably the one I always end up liking on like anthology series, like the vampire ones, like the one from Masters of Horror that had the kid that was the star of Alan Strange. Like that for some reason became like my favorite episode of Masters of Horror, and I remember like really wishing that that one was like a full movie. And this one was the same kind of one where, like, out of all the stories, I thought that one could have been like its own story. The only story on here that I thought was just kind of strange because it was like this, I don't know, was the one with you know, Justin Long going into the movie. I thought it was kind of cool, but I just thought it was like, I wish it was like a little more they could have done with the footage. And so because it was like they were trying to put him into a movie and stuff like that, like he had this virtual reality device to put you in the movie, and I was just like thinking I actually kept wishing that they would put him into the original Creepshow. Like, to me, that would have been even more of a weird meta thing to do. But but this is definitely a really fun series. Really glad that it's getting, you know, physical releases as well for this one. It has on here though, feature wise it does have the Creepshow animated special on here, as well as the Creepshow holiday special is included as well. It has on here exclusive never before seen featurettes, behind the raw footage on here, and then it also has in here a little mini comic book, you know, of the films, you know, about basically about each of the episodes that are on here, you know, as well. But no, it's very, like I said, very fun series. Like I said, really glad that it's getting physical releases as well for this one. And the next one I got here is from RLJ Entertainment as well. It's a movie here called Werewolves Within. This is a really fun movie. The one actress in here, I kept on thinking too, where did I know her from? Because I kept on like, and then I was like, oh, she's in all those commercials for Geico. But there's a lot of people in this movie that were TV people. There's like a ton of actresses and actors in here that were like in a lot of TV shows and stuff like that. Like, I was watching with my brother and he's like, oh yeah, this person's on this show. I think like The Unicorn or something like that he was mentioning. But there's a lot of people TV-wise on here. But this is basically basically, though, about Sam Richardson's character, and he comes into this small town where they're going to be doing like a gas pipeline that's going to be built through, and there's a lot of like complaints and people that are against that being done, and like he comes there to be, I think he was like, he's going to be the new, you know, new forest ranger out there, and basically the second he gets into the town, though, there's all sorts of problems. And it ends up basically being that there are these attacks going on, which are like these sort of werewolf attacks that they don't know what it is at first. And it's essentially them going to try to get to the bottom of what it is and exactly what, you know, what is happening and everything. But it is a really, really fun movie. Definitely one I would recommend you guys check out. The other ones here, these are from Mill Creek. And I want to let you guys know these ones are available. The first one here is Ultraman. And this is Ultra Mandana here. I think that's how you say this. I might be saying this one totally wrong. And this is the complete series here, plus the specials. And this is on DVD. Here, I'll show you guys, though, a look inside for this one. Here's a look, though, at the discs for this one here. And then in there, too, it has, like, an episode guide, which has, like, you know, a little episode guide for the episodes that are on here. Does it show the monsters, too? Sometimes they show the monsters that are in here. I don't think it shows the picture of the monsters. No, it doesn't show the monsters on this one. But like I said, one of you guys know that this one was available. The other one, which is available for the first time on Blu-ray, and this is the complete series set here. And I remember watching this one back in the day, and I used to always kind of confuse this and mix it up with the other show, Bewitched, for some reason. Like, I don't know why. I was always, like, as a kid, mixing these two up. And I can't remember, honestly, which one I watched more, but I think it was probably Bewitched that I watched a little bit more. But this is the I Dream of Jeannie, the complete series here. Like I said, available for the first time on Blu-ray. The show looks great here on Blu-ray, and I'll show you guys, though, a look inside here, the discs and everything. So here's a look here, and this one has seasons one and season two. Here's a look, though, here at the back, and you see, like, stills from the episodes and everything. But I always love these complete series sets. I don't know, I don't like, for some reason, things when it's, like, just, like, random seasons of stuff. I always like these complete sets, especially when they're all kind of together and you have, like, all in a smaller size box and stuff like this. The other one here, this is the complete seasons 3, 4, and 5 here of the show. Here's a look, though, at the back here, and here's a look, though, inside here. But a really fun show, like I said, one that I used to watch all the time, you know, back in the day. Now, the next ones here, these ones are all from MovieZing.com. This is another complete series set here. And I'll have a link below where you guys can order these ones for the best price. And this is one that, no matter what, when I think of this, I just think of, you know, Patty and Selma in The Simpsons. Like, it's like, I can't, like, get that out of my head. I just think of that. Because I always remember, like, you know, they were in The Simpsons, like, Patty and Selma. I don't even know if they talk about this at all anymore in there. I don't think they do, because the show is not on anymore, unless they, like, are doing it now for the new reboot. But they used to love this show. We're always talking about it and, like, swooning over the guy and everything. So, and here, this is the complete series here, collection here of MacGyver, the complete collection. And this show ran for 7 seasons. This is basically, though, you know, about this guy who's, like, has all these kind of gadgets and can kind of, like, always get out of every kind of, like, situation. He's about to, like, explode and he finds a way out, has all these type of tools and things like that to get away. It's a very fun show. I'm glad to have the whole series, because I've never owned, like, seasons of this. I've only ever, like, randomly seen, like, a couple episodes here and there, because I always honestly think of more nowadays MacGruber, which was, like, the parody that they made for SNL, and then they made the movie. But, you know, so I always kind of think of that, because MacGruber was a parody of MacGyver. But here's a look, though, at the discs here. So the complete first season here, I'll go through all the different ones to show you guys the artwork. The complete second season here, the complete third season, and then the complete fourth season, and then season 5, and then 6, and then 7. So, like I said, really cool to have these all available, and they have never been available either on Blu-ray before. The next one is also from MovieZing.com. This is one here, and it's also from 1091. It's a movie here called The Electric Jesus. And this is a fun movie about this guy. He's kind of like this producer who's trying to put together this, like, Christian metal, like, rock band and everything, and he's kind of trying to take them on this tour. And it's basically like these kids who kind of have never really been around and, like, done much, and they kind of, like, real sheltered and at home all the time, and they kind of are now going out with this guy, and then when they go out on the road and everything on this tour, and they kind of, like, go crazy, and it's kind of, like, about them, like, this fish out of water kind of situation about them going crazy and all the stuff that happens and everything. It's a very, very fun movie. The other one here is a crazy film. This is from Freestyle Digital, and this is also from MovieZing.com. This is called Chompy and the Girls, and this one is so incredibly weird. It's like this girl, like, it's basically, she's in this park, and she sees this really weird guy, like, with this big mouth that's opening up really huge. And it's like this enormous mouth thing. And it's like very creepy. And it's essentially, though, you know, about like when he sees this mouth and like this guy like swallow up someone with the mouth. And then basically, though, this guy is kind of coming after him, you know, her after this and everything. It's kind of like this whole big thing, you know, and it's like really, like I said, it's really out there and really weird, but a really interesting movie. The other one here is from MovieZing.com as well, and this is also from Freestyle Digital releasing, and this is one called The Invisible Mother, and this one has Richard Riley in the film. This is one that plays out like a kind of plays out like a fairy tale kind of film, and like a little Argento kind of vibes and stuff on here. Has that kind of Suspiria kind of feel, a little bit to the lighting and stuff like that. And this is basically about this girl that goes back to her grandmother, and then like the grandmother's having all these kind of weird things going on. She's seeing weird things, and essentially though, the girl that goes, when she goes back there, she starts to see weird things as well. And it's kind of like, is there something going on at this house? And is there a reason for these visions? Something happening here. It's an interesting movie. Like I said, very visual film, very highly stylized. The next one here is from, MovieZing.com as well. And I don't know the company for this. I'll put a link below, though. And this is a movie here called Barry. And this is a fun movie. This is basically, though, this girl gets this giant teddy bear, like one of those like obnoxiously large, huge teddy bears, like those ones at Costco that they would have. I don't know if they even have them anymore, that are like as big as like two people combined or something, like enormous. And basically though, this teddy bear though is going and, you know, think, you know, it's either, is this kid doing it or is it a teddy bear going and killing people? And it becomes this whole big thing. It's a very funny, fun movie. A lot of people I knew, you know, were in this one as well. So it was cool seeing so many people I knew in here, in this one here as well. The other one here from MovieZing.com, and this is one, and this is also from White Hair Pick Productions. It's a movie here called Homecoming Massacre, and this is basically though, it's about the guy that was like locked away for killing somebody. He was away for like 10 years, and he ends up getting, you know, out. And it's basically like, you know, kind of later, years later, and the guy is like putting on this crazy clown makeup and kind of going crazy and going after people and stuff like that. Is definitely a fun movie. This one has on here a blooper reel theatrical trailer on this one here as well. Now the next ones here, these are some Australian releases, and these are from Via Vision. Now some of these ones, I'll let you guys know which ones are region locked, but the first three ones are region free, so you guys can watch these ones in any US DVD or Blu-ray player. And this is Good Girls season 3 here, and this is a show though that in the U.S. doesn't get physical releases at all, I don't believe. I don't think it's actually, I don't think so. Or maybe not the later seasons. I might be wrong, but I don't, maybe like they did for the first season or something, but I don't think for the after season one. But this is Good Girls season 3 here. And this is a fun show. I have not seen all the episodes of this, but I have watched episodes here and there of this one. But this has, you know, the complete third season here. I'll show you guys, though, a look inside here at the discs for this one. The other one is another one that definitely doesn't have a physical media release in the U.S. And this is LA's Finest, the complete series here. And this is the show, I think this is like on Spectrum, is where it aired in the U.S. as an original on Spectrum. And it's a you know, a police series, which is actually a fun series with Jessica Alba and Gabrielle Union on here. And how many seasons did this go for? So it went for all 26 episodes. So I guess it ran for two different seasons for this one here. And this one is region free as well. So you guys can watch this one in any US player. And then the other one here is a collection of movies here. This is the this is a Hallmark Channel original films series. And these are also region free. And this is a Signed, Sealed, Delivered, the movie collection here. And this is an 11 disc set. And I'll let you guys know which ones are on here. So this one has five different discs here. This has Lost Without You, Higher Ground, Home Again, The Road Less Traveled, and To the Altar. Those are the ones that are included in this set. And this one has Signed, Sealed, and Delivered for Christmas, From Paris with Love, Truth Be Told, The Impossible Dream, From the Heart, and One in a Million here, you know, as well. You know, the ones that are included in here in this set. Now the other ones here, now these ones, I think this one was region locked. This was the one that was region locked. And this one, I don't know how you say this one. Cavastel? I cannot figure out how to say this one. But this is the complete series here. And this one has on here a new introduction to the series. Brothers in Magic, Geoffrey Brodlin and Robin Davis are reunited after 30 years on this one. A commentary track on here, on this one here as well. But like I said, this one is region locked. This is region 4 locked for this one. And then the other one here, this is also region locked. This is region B locked for this one. And this is fried green tomatoes, the film that stars Kathy Bates here. And this one, like I said, this one has on here feature-wise deleted scenes, outtakes, moments of discovery, the making of Fried Green Tomatoes, director's commentary track on here, John Evanette's director's notes, production photographs, and poster campaign on this one. And the next one I got here is from SRS Cinema, and it's a movie here called Hell on a Shelf. And this is a fun movie. This is basically, though, about, like, these guys that have, like, a paranormal kind of show where they, like, investigate, you know, hauntings and stuff like that. And basically, they end up going and kind of hearing about, like, this house where there's, like, haunting things happening, and they believe it has to do with, like, this doll. And it's basically them going there and kind of, like, you know, documenting the whole thing, you know, with, like, hidden cameras and stuff like that, and kind of, like, showing the evidence of what they come across and everything. But a really, really fun movie. This one has on here, though, feature-wise, has a commentary track on this one, as well as a trailer, and as well as trailers for other SRS cinema releases on this one. The next ones here, these are ones I just want you guys know are available, these releases. The first one, and these are all from MVD, and this is one here called Athens Inside Out 2, Red Turns Into Blue. This is for the makers of the legendary documentary, Athens, Georgia, Inside Out, on here. And this has performances by Cindy Wilson of the B-52s, Drive-By Tuckers on here, Elf Power on here. Like I said, one of you guys know that this one was available. The other one here is one called Harvey, and I think this was an episode or a movie here. I think it said it originally aired in September 22nd, 1958 on here. It's one called Harvey, and it has Fred Gwynne in it, Art Carney on this one here, Elizabeth Montgomery. Like I said, one of you guys know that this one was available. The other one here, and this is from MVD as well, and this is one called Big House Doll. And this is the digitally remastered version of this one. This is from Mutant Sorority Pictures Presents. So I don't think I've ever seen things from this company. So it's a company called Mutant Sorority Presents Big Dollhouse. And the other one here from MVD, and this is also from Film Rise, is a movie which, from John Leguizamo. And this is called Dark Blood. And this one has a photo gallery in this one, as well as a theatrical trailer. And this one here is from Film Rise as well, from MVD. And this is one here called Surge. And this one has a theatrical trailer, interviews on here with the director, as well as actor Ben Winslow, and a photo gallery on this one. And then this one here is from MVD, and it's from The Film Detective. And it's one here called... it's the special edition. This is the fabulous Dorsey here. And this one here has on here the Dorsey and Films, the original insert essay by Don Stradley, full commentary track by author Jennifer Churchill, and the fabulous 40 bands on the big screen, brand new documentary on here, as well for this one. And it also has like a booklet in here with stuff about the film and everything. And the last one here to let you guys know is available, and this is from Unearthed Films. It's a movie here called Plazidim? I don't know how to, I think... Plazidurium? Something like that. I don't know how to say that one for sure. Like I said, one of you guys know this one's available from Artsploitation Films, and this has a commentary track on here with the cast and crew, deleted scenes, music video, and a trailer on this one. But anyway, though, guys, that was all for the review portion of this video, and like I always say, if you guys enjoy these videos, definitely give this video a thumbs up. Thanks again for watching and subscribing, and I'll see you guys later.